frontier of a decade not too long for our own. The human race faced a threat that creates a very existence. And this terrifying enemy surfaced as such enemies often do, from the most unlikely and innocent of places.
What? I could have sworn it hadn't been but the old Chinese man spoke to the anchorless for a top 95.
Thank you. Oh, Girl, I don't know who this mensch is you're hanging out with, but he sure is has this to your help.
That's for sure. But I can't leave him.
And why not?
He'd get angry. And if he does this to me when he likes me, imagine what he'd do if he got mad.
So dump the child, find another guy, and let him protect you.
And we've got the perfect one picked out.
A little botanical genius.
And we're not talking about George Washington Carver.
Seymour?
Bingo!
Oh, we're just friends. Oh, I could never be Seymour's girl. I got a past.
And 4 months of time.
That's right.
Oh, I don't even deserve a sweet. Consider it a suddenly successful guy like Seymour.
This child suffers from low self-image.
You have a point.
She has a problem.
Between us.
We're closer renovation versus being up and grooming, cause customers are flocking and business has been booming. We need refrigeration in our new improved display, so we're closer renovation today.
Yes, this is the flow shopping work on Channel 5 News. And yes, the audio is used exclusively here.
We're closer decoration, this gorgeous has been smiling, so now we're doing her painting. Improving every time. We'll make your shift to show we sell our little shopping bag. Tomorrow we'll be open again.
Seymour, you're finished yet?
Oh, China, these bandits make it kind of hard.
You've been getting hurt so much lately.
Yeah. Excuse me, every time I'm recruiting this year, I slip. We're closer renovation. We're swabbing down and grooming. Businesses have been thriving since our beauties are blooming. The closer has suffering made with the customers instead.
Another.
It's right over there. But if you'd like to find some others flopping down the
see Audrey too? You better come back tomorrow, man. This shop is closed.
Well, I'm not here to buy posies, girls. I'm here to pick up my date.
Your date? You don't happen to be talking about a girl with a black eye? Several other medical problems?
As a matter of fact, I am.
That's it! The only one I know!
You say raise this thing, right?
Well, if I were you, I sure as hell wouldn't leave it in a skid row dump like this. This thing could give you a ticket to the stars. You can go to any floral shop in town, name your price. Somebody would make you a goddamn partner with their hands on this thing. Somebody talking to you?
Oh, no. Excuse me.
Excuse me? What?
Oh, excuse me, doctor.
That's better. Now, I'm telling you, kid, this thing is a big green gold mine. Get your ass out of this dump and take the plant with you. What? Must make skid row forests? It's a joke. You hear what I'm saying?
Hear you.
He hears him.
Shouldn't we be leaving now? I'm sorry.
I'm sorry. What?
Doctor, I'm sorry. Doctor.
Yeah, train, Amistad. Well, my bike's outside and double parked. But you remember what I said. I mean it. You think about it.
Think about it.
You'll think about it.
You do that. Okay, Audrey. Let's go. Got the handcuffs?
They're right in my bag.
I don't like that, Mr. Bush. You should hear the way he talks, Archie.
God, if Hamilton's only kid just said to hold it over.
But what if she looks so unhealthy? It's enough to make you sick.
If he left me, if she won't left me, why then I'd be right back where I started and was broken, starving.
Sweet and good, beautiful as she is, she deserves a prince on a sinister creep like him.
What a bank bonds.
What a mouse.
Said be followed and be ref. That's what I did, you see more left.
He's a disgrace to that profession.
Seymour!
Sir?
Seymour. How would you like to be my son?
Would you like to be my own adopted boy? I never liked to much before, but from the castle to New York.
Oh!
came and found me. Thanks a million for making the magic you do. Thanks to you, sweet Petunia. Wish it's taken, Petunia. And someday when I own this whole shop, I'll remember I owe it to you.
God, Tui, who cares if I've been a little on the anemic side the past few weeks? So what if I've been a few to these spells? A little unhappiness? It's all been worth it, pal. Well, I'm a little hungry. I'm gonna run into Schmendrick to get a bite to eat. I'll see you in the morning. I haven't got much left. Just give me a few more instances and we'll start on the left hand again.
Feed me!
I beg your pardon.
Feed me!
Tui, you talked, you opened up, you tried your thing and you said,
feed me, Crowborn, feed me now.
I can't!
But I'm starving!
Oh boy, look, maybe I squeeze out of this one, but
I need some food! More! Give me more!
But I've got you more! What do you want me to do? Slit my wrists? How about I run out of the corner and get you some nice chopped sirloin?
Must be blood.
Tui, it's disgusting.
Must be fresh.
I don't want to hear this.
Feed me!
Does it have to be human?
Feed me!
Does it have to be mine? Where am I supposed to get it?
If I can move, who's to say I can't do anything I want?
Like what?
Like deliver, pal! Let's see you get everything. Your secret, greasy, hard desire. How'd you like a Cadillac car? Or a shot on Jack Paul? How about a great big penny tomorrow? You're gonna get it.
Thanks for passing it off of us.
Would you like to be a big real?
Stop it, take it over, pal. I'm supposed to learn to
and was screwed on!
Or if that hurt!
Move it!
Another day. Now for the girl, now for the I've got something to show you.
Can't wait till tomorrow.
It won't take long. I have a chance.
popping through the wardrobe like you told me to, and just... ta-da! What do you think? You don't like it?
I don't know.
I'll take it off. I'll take it back. I'll burn it. Just don't cry, please. Oh, look what I did. Oh, I only wanted to impress you. That's all I meant to do.
Well, I don't know what's come over me lately. I guess I've been a little under the weather lately.
It's hard, isn't it? You've been down the dark service since the mysterious disappearance. You miss him, don't you?
Miss him? I never felt so relieved as when they told me he'd vanished. It was like a miracle. Not to mention all the money I saved on Epsom salts and ace bandages.
What's the matter?
I feel guilty, I guess. I mean, if he met with foul play or some terrible accident of some kind, well, it's partly my fault, you see. Because... secretly, I wished it.
Audrey, you should waste one more minute worrying about that creep. There's a lot of guys who do anything about it with you. Nice guys.
I don't deserve a nice guy, Seymour.
That's not true.
You don't know the half of it. I've led a terrible life.
Audrey,
I deserve a creep like Orange Cabello, DDS. You know where I met him? In the gutter.
The gutter?
The gutter. It's a night spot. I worked there on our nights off when we weren't making much money. They put on cheap and tasteless outfits. Not nice ones like this. Low and nasty apparel.
Audrey, that's all behind you now. You don't have anything to be ashamed of. You're a nice person. I always knew you were. Underneath all the ace bandages and bruises, you know what I saw? A girl I respected. And I still do. Lift up your head. Wash off your mascara. You take my greenness, wipe the lipstick away. Show me your face. Clean as the morning. No, things were bad, but now they're okay. 'Cause suddenly Seymour is standing beside you. You don't need no makeup. Don't have to pretend.
He snapped his fingers, me, I'd say she-
my employees.
Please, Mr. Daddy.
Oh, don't you, Mr. Daddy, me, cowboy. Audrey, perhaps you could excuse Seymour and I for a little while. Perhaps you could go visit your dentist friend.
That's not very nice, Dad. You know he disappeared.
Oh, did he? Oh, forgive me, boy chick.
Seymour, what's he talking about? What's he doing?
Why don't you go along, he asked. I'll call for you if that's okay.
Of course it is. Good night, Seymour. Good night, Mr. Mushnick.
After my lawyer's appointment, I was called into the police station.
The police?
Yeah. It seems like you're doing a routine investigation into the disappearance of the motorcycle dentist. And when they did, they found a Mushnick Skid Row Forest bag in his office. Exactly what I asked myself. But then I started to notice all the funny things I noticed around. Like little red dots all over the linoleum.
I suppose the point you're punching, it's stained.
Oh, how hard it is to keep things clean around here. Especially when the garbage only comes once a month.
What are you talking about? Where are you going?
If you want to get rid of something fast, you better not do it on Skid Row.
I don't know what you're talking about.
A dentist uniform!
Got your number now.
I noticed it last week and I didn't think twice about it.
He knows just what you got.
And the little red dot seemed innocent enough.
You got no place.
But then I catch you kissing the dentist's girlfriend.
You got nowhere to
when it began to smell like a motive.
He knows
once
your
he moves out. But they're not about the dots, the uniform, the girlfriend!
They do it!
Then come with me to the police station and tell them that!
You've got his back.
Just so my conscience is clear.
You know he's on.
If you don't come with me, I'm going to tell them myself.
He's gonna turn you in.
The police, when you come,
they're gonna put you in jail.
Thank you.
think so. Good thing I can't hear in person. Place to meet you, kid. Skip to that William Morris Agency. In the game, since you, such a meeting of pleasure is yours. And let my firm represent you. We want to book you on lecturing tours. College campus broadery club. The kind of bookings my office did to you. Show them plant and talk at your questions. Educational printing.
My future's starting. I have to let it stick with the kids and cheat my bank accounts.
Running this place over.
hasn't begun in a very long time. Audrey, can I ask you something?
Anything.
Suppose that there never been bad in Audrey's team. That it was just me. Would you still like me?
I still love you, Seymour.
Then it's settled.
What's settled?
A gun?
Bullets, and rat poison, and a machete. And right after that magazine gets here and takes that picture, you know who bites the dust?
Seymour!
Right, they'll snap the picture. We'll be famous. I'll take that TV show and live a nice, quiet life. No more knife feedings. No more square root for blood!
So big and strong, and you're so
fast. I feel so terrible.
Seymour Crabble.
Go away.
Patrick Martin, Marketing and Licensing Division, World Botanical Enterprises. I got a gilt-edged proposition for you, boy.
Don't want to hear it.
Oh, wait, wait a minute. Let me explain in more detail. It's a very simple licensing deal. We take samples, develop little Audrey tunes, and sell them, of course, across the nation. Pretty soon, every household in America will have one. Now, I got a truck waiting outside, so if you don't mind, I'll start taking cuttings right now. Imagine, Audrey tunes everywhere. Why, with the right advertising, this could be bigger than hula hoops.
Bigger than hula hoops?
Oh, much bigger.
Every household in America, thousands of you, eat it. That's what you had in mind all along, isn't it?
No shit, Sherlock.
This isn't about plants. This is about, well, conquest.
And I want to thank you.
So am I.
Feed me. Mr. Crabble?